Okay, Michael, what have we learned?
Well, we learned a definition for feature selection, which was getting a subset of the features to feed to some, I think we mostly talked about supervised training algorithms or learning algorithms after the selection has taken place.
Right.
We made a distinction between wrapping and filtering.
Was that supposed to be filtering?
Yeah, I don't know how the filtering sounds.
It sounded more like slurping.
Yeah, I'm not sure that my rapping actually sounded like rapping either.
It didn't, but I wasn't going to say anything. So what else did we learn besides you like sound effects? So we learned about feature selection. We defined that. We discussed the difference between filtering methods for feature selection and wrapping methods for feature selection. What did we learn about them?
That wrapping is slow, but actually seems like it solves the problem that matters.
Yeah, so let's call that slow but useful.
Is that useful in the sense
yes.
that you defined it?
Mm-hmm.
Or at least can be useful. Whereas filtering is simpler, possibly faster, but maybe misses the point.
Probably faster, yeah. But ignores bias. Okay. So what else? Is that it?
Well, so we specifically learned about the distinction between features being useful versus them being relevant.
That's right. So relevant things are things that give you information about the classification problem or the regression problem that you care about. But useful features are things that help you to actually do the learning given some specific algorithm.
Right. And you reminded me what a Bayes optimal classifier was, which I guess I should have known already, but somehow I didn't understand how it fit into this context.
Yeah. Well, the main power of Bayes optimal classifiers is that it's sort of the gold standard. It's the ultimate that you could do if you had everything and all the time in the world.
Could I say that relevance is usefulness with regard to the Bayes optimal classifier?
Yes, actually you could. I like that. It's a special case of usefulness.
Oh, wait. There's something else that you talked about, which was
yes.
strong and weak relevance.
Right.
And in a sense, that relevant features have a kind of kryptonite, in the sense that you can make them not strong just by putting a copy of them into the space.
Right. I like that. The kryptonite is copy. Well done. That's because you're no longer indispensable if I have a copy of you.
That's right. You and your evil twin now resides in your parallel universe.
So what do you think that means for us? Are we strongly relevant, weakly relevant, or useless? And those are your choices.
I'm going to say I'm weakly relevant because I think I correlate with truth, assuming the subset of other people in the world is the empty set.
Fair enough. So then by that definition, do I get to be weakly relevant?
You're at least weakly relevant.
Very good. But are we useful?
We're going to say yes, as far as our students know.
Well, I guess that's the way we'll find out ultimately is how will they do on the course.
It's true. It's in some sense completely in their hands.
Right. So in fact, this course is a wrapper method over features. And this is the first iteration.
Interesting.
Well, that was deep. I feel like we should end on that.
I do too.
Okay, well then I will see you next time when we will talk about feature transformation.
Transformation.
Well done. Bye.
Bye.